Hi, I'm Norman Wildberger, and in this video I'm going to explain to you how quadrants, the fundamental concept from rational trigonometry, actually comes about from the ancient Greeks, the way they thought about geometry. Euclid and his followers mostly concerned with points, lines, and circles. Greek geometry used the idea of parallel lines and perpendicular lines, and also congruence of figures. So for example, this segment here was considered equal to this segment, not because they measured the same on a ruler, but because we could pick that one up and superimpose it on the other. So the Greeks measured the separation of two points A and B, not with a ruler, but with a process they called quadrature, which roughly means creating a square and considering the area of that square. So we'll call Q of AB, the quadrants between A and B, to be the area of that square built on that segment. That's going to be the notion that replaces distance. So it's really just the square of the distance, but algebraically it has many better properties. Here are the two main results in the subject. These are the two pillars upon which everything else is based. Pythagoras' theorem, which has played an important role in geometry since day one, and the triple quad formula, which is sort of the baby sister, which is hardly known at all. Here's the way the ancient Greeks thought about Pythagoras' theorem. You have a triangle A1, A2, A3, where these two sides, A1, A3, and A2, A3, are perpendicular. Then the three quadrances of the sides, that square Q1, that square Q2, and that square Q3, are related in the simplest of possible ways. Q1 plus Q2 equals Q3. That's actually the way Euclid formulated that result. No distances are involved, okay? It's just about quadrances. Here is the triple quad formula. It concerns three points A1, A2, A3, which are now collinear. They're in a straight line. Those three points create three squares. Square there is called Q1, square there has area Q2, and the square there has area Q3. And the question is, what is the relationship between these three areas? The answer is given by the triple quad formula. The Q1 plus Q2 minus Q3 all squared equals 4 times Q1 times Q2. Those are the basis of rational trigonometry, as we'll see. And our first objective now is to prove those theorems. So I'm going to explain to you exactly why they are true in a way that you can follow and understand. All right, let's start with the proof of Pythagoras' theorem. So right here is the triangle that we start with, the right triangle. And on this side here is the square, and on this side here is the square. In this big square here, I have not only Q1 and Q2, but altogether four copies of that original triangle. A green one, a red one, and a black one, and a blue one. They're all the same area. So the idea is we're going to shuffle things around in this picture just by translating, but that'll preserve areas. So what we're first going to do is we're going to slide that black triangle over to the left, and we're going to slide the blue triangle up. So the black triangle comes over here, and the blue triangle comes over there. And now the white area here is still the same as the white area was over there, namely Q1 plus Q2. Now there's just enough room to slide the original red triangle down. So we do that. We slide it right down, so now it's down there. Now the area that's left over is exactly the square on the hypotenuse. It's what we call Q3. And so the area we started with, Q1 plus Q2, must equal the area that we end up with, which is Q3. And that's the end of the proof. Now to prove the triple quad formula, we'll first need a little lemma. Lemma means preliminary result. Okay, and the lemma that we need is this. We've got a little rectangle here, not a square, a rectangle with area Q. And on one side, we have a built-in square, whose area is Q2, and on the other side, another square whose area is Q1. So in this example, this area, this rectangle has area 6, and that area is 9, and that area is 4. So the relationship is between Q and Q1 and Q2. The relationship is that the square of Q is equal to Q1 times Q2. So for example, 6 squared is equal to 9 times 4. And it's almost obvious from this picture. We're going to use that lemma now to prove the triple quad formula. So now let's look at the triple quad formula, which I remind you concerns three collinear points, A1, A2, A3, and the square built on the large segment, we'll call that area Q3. The square on this segment, that's Q1 right there. And the square on the segment here, I've slid up now, so it's right in that corner there. So there's Q1, there's Q2, and Q3 is the whole thing. And we want to establish the relationship between these three numbers. Well, if we take the big area, Q3, and we subtract Q1 and Q2, then we get the area of these two rectangles. Now, these two rectangles have the same shape. So if we call that area Q, then Q3 minus Q1 minus Q2 is 2 times Q. And now we square this formula. We square both sides. If we square the left-hand side, we can write it as Q1 plus Q2 minus Q3 all squared. And when we square the right-hand side, we get 4Q squared, but Q squared is, by our lemma, Q1 times Q2. So on the right-hand side, we get 4Q1 Q2. And that is the triple quad formula, and that's the proof. Now, I'll leave it to you as an important exercise to rearrange this equation into another form, which shows that the formula is actually symmetrical between Q1, Q2, and Q3. If you work with distances, the relationship between the three distances is not symmetrical, but with quadrances it is. Here's the symmetrical version. Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3 all squared is 2 times Q1 squared plus Q2 squared plus Q3 squared. So that's another form, an equivalent form of the triple quad formula. Now, this formula is very intimately connected with a result that's usually called Heron's formula, which I showed you in my first lecture, but which I want to restate for you today. I'm not going to prove it today, we will in a subsequent lecture, but this restatement I prefer to call Archimedes' theorem, because Archimedes understood Heron's formula before Heron did. So it concerns an arbitrary triangle, A1, A2, A3, and the three quadrances, which we'll always label like this. There's Q1, Q2, and Q3. So I remind you that Q3, for example, really means the area of the square built on that segment. Okay, so Archimedes' theorem, our version of Heron's formula, is this. 16 times the square of the area of this triangle is equal to this expression, just the difference between one side and the other side of the triple quad formula. 4 times Q1, Q2 minus Q1 plus Q2 minus Q3 all squared. And exactly the same way that we arrange that, we can rearrange this to be the difference between the two sides of this symmetrical version. This theorem is more powerful than the triple quad formula because it reduces to it in the special case when these three points become collinear. In that case, the area is obviously zero, and this being equal to zero just becomes the triple quad formula. All right, so that's really good. We've established the main concept, quadrance, that replaces distance in rational trigonometry. Next lecture, I'm going to show you what to do about angle, how to get rid of angle, how to replace it with something much nicer algebraically and more pleasant, called spread. All right, the spread between two lines. It's going to be quite good. We're going to go back to the ancient Greeks again and get our inspiration from some understanding of trigonometry related to astronomy. I'm Norm Wildberger. I hope you join me, and thanks for listening.